Good morning. I hope that you and your family are well. Hashem should keep us all safe and healthy and send a refuah shlema to those who need it. And please, God, we should see Hashem's brachas every single day, even during this difficult time. This Shabbos, we're going to read a very intriguing story about a man called Pinchas. Pinchas goes down in history as a radical. And of course, in today's world, to be known as a radical is not necessarily always a good thing. Except it depends on what you're radical about. It reminds me a little bit of a story that I heard right at the beginning of the lockdown. One of the great sages, somebody criticized him and said, how come it is that whenever people raise a question that is related to whether you should do a mitzvah or whether you should protect people's lives, you always say protect lives, even at the cost of important mitzvahs, and even perhaps when there's not such a great threat to life? Why are you so lenient about the observance of mitzvahs? And the rabbi replied, I'm not lenient about the observance of mitzvahs. I'm a radical about protecting life. Pinchas was a radical about protecting life, which is ironic because the story of Pinchas is the story of a man who kills two people, apparently in cold blood, although the Torah vindicates him that it was in fact the correct approach. Because he was radical. Pinchas saw that 22,000 people had died in one day because of a plague that had infected the Jewish camp. And when he saw this happening in front of his eyes, he realized that somebody has to do something. And he was insightful enough to recognize that the plague was the result of the behavior of the people at the time, and somebody had to put a stop to it. And he took a great risk in doing that, because putting a stop to the plague actually put his own life on the line. He could have been attacked by any member of the community. Who do you think you are, taking the law into your own hands? He could have been killed in self-defense by the man who he attacked. So he took a huge risk. But the risk to himself, he felt, was valuable enough to protect the lives of others. And for that, Hashem says, Hineni noisen lo yesbrisi shalom. Hashem promises him, I give you my covenant of peace. This is so apt for our current circumstances. None of us is being asked to risk our lives to keep other people safe. But we are being asked to do things that are inconvenient for us in our lives in order to keep other people safe. And you might adopt an attitude that says, well, you know, there's so much spread of the virus in any event. What's the difference what I do? It's already out there. This is what the Torah is teaching us. When it comes to life, a person is expected to be radical in the protection of life. And when we do, when we really care about other people, especially at this time of the year, the 3 weeks, which is a time we're supposed to show extra care and concern for others, when we are willing to do things that might be uncomfortable for ourselves in order to help and protect others, as Pinchas did in this week's parasha, then please God, we get the blessing that he got in this week's parasha, shalom, peace. Peace of mind, peace in our own homes, peace as a community, and please God, global peace, which obviously will come to its ultimate fruition with the coming of Mashiach. May that happen immediately. Have a wonderful Shabbos. Stay safe and stay sane.